Hello, everyone, and welcome back to episode 6 of my Train Simulator 2017 series. I know I mentioned that I considered the TGV as the subject for today's video, but I am instead on the Great Western Railways. We are in Wales, and today we will be driving a high-speed train, an HST. Welcome aboard 1B59, a Great Western Railway service from London Paddington to Swansea. Disruption in the Sodbury area has diverted our train via Bath and Bristol Temple-Meads. To get back on track, you'll need to change ends at Bristol Temple-Meads and Bristol Parkway. Set the train up and get going when ready. So, let us do just that. I'm going to adjust the HUD a little bit. There we go. Get ourselves into forward, hit the AWS, and go nowhere. Yes. Alright, cool. Our train has started successfully. Let's take a look around our cab here. We cannot go yet. Ooh, look at that. Nice light. We are waiting for a Freightliner locomotive that is cruising down the line there. I tried out the first 10 minutes of the scenario yesterday just to see what it was like. I hope that I've adjusted the volume properly so the roar from that diesel behind me is not too terrible, but let me know in the comments if it is in fact too loud, or if my voice is not clear enough. I think I've gotten the microphone down pretty well, but do let me know. I will take a look at these later, but we certainly have a lot of switches and dials on our dashboard here in case of fire. Master controller must be moved to off before this button will operate. Now you know. There's that Freightliner switching over in front of us. I'd imagine once it gets sufficiently far, we'll be able to get going. I'm going to head outside the cab for a moment. Take a look at that. Beautiful. Very nice. Also, look at the lighting on this train. They have the paint quality really well rendered there. Beautiful. Very nice. Now we should just about... There we go. We're set to go. Let us drop the brakes and get going. We have a speed limit of 70 here, but we have a 25 coming up, so we probably won't want to speed up too much. I'll put us at 80% throttle and see what happens. It is 6:16 in the evening on this apparent summer's day, so it looks like the sun will be setting as we go. If you look behind me for a moment, you can see that the lighting is very nice here. Got the shadows of the trees passing by on our cab. Let's keep an eye on that speed. I need to stop at 25. Or not stop accelerating at 25, I should say. Whoops. I almost got it. There we go. We're safe. Looks like we're going over a little river here. As we head towards Bristol Temple-Meads, platform 13. Number of crossovers there. There's a branch going off to somewhere. I'd imagine... I don't know, actually. I have no idea. Gotta watch that 25 mile per hour speed limit, but looks like we're okay just cruising along. Ding-a-ling. At the speed we are at, that was an AWS ramp. The ding-a-ling meant that everything is okay. We are going under the speed limit. Another ding-a-ling. No ding-a-ling there. We have a green on through. I believe that was actually the second part of the AWS ramp, the one that you need to not have gone past too soon after the other one, or you're probably going too fast. Here's the Erling. Oh, in fact, there is an AWS warning that I need to slow down for that 15. So that's helpful. Let us slow down for the 15. Put on 28% brake. And just cruise right on down. I might even be able to release it now. Nope, need a little bit more brake. 14% brake? Yeah, that'll bring me down. The sun is dropping towards the horizon in front of us. That's nice. There we go. Now we're under 15. We can just keep cruising along. We are going on a perfectly flat track, although for some reason to me it looks like it's slightly uphill. Must just be a trick of the perspective. We are curving into Bristol Temple-Meads platform 13 now. There's another AWS ramp. I know from trying this, as I said, for 10 minutes yesterday, that that other HST is going to be rolling out before us, so we will be following it at least for a short time. In fact, there it goes. It is heading off now. You can see the smoke and hear it starting to build up speed as it pulls out there. Very nice. Let me look ahead and keep an eye on stopping at the end of the platform. I see we have a couple of passengers waiting for us here. As the tech said at the beginning of the run, we are being diverted here in order to turn around and head in a different direction. So that is what we shall do. And we'll have to spend a little bit of time at this station. We are almost at the end of the platform. Let's be a little bit more enthusiastic with that break. Maybe a little too enthusiastic. Beautiful. HST. We will stop at the HST marker. Nice. All right. Dropped a 42% brake. Open the doors. And now we're going to need to switch ends. So for that, I'm going to have to bring... Oops, what did I press? I pressed something. I'm going to have to bring the HUD up, change ends to the other end, get us into forward here. AWS. Yep. There we go. All right. So now we are set to leave shortly, whenever everybody finishes boarding. You can see that little red line going across indicating that we will have to wait a bit. I will drop the HUD again. How am I going to do that? There we go. All right. And I'm actually going to hop out of the train so we can take a little bit of a look around. And I clicked on the right screen this time. I did not... Hello, everyone. I did not bring us out of Train Simulator. So, GWR. Isn't that nice? Dark forest green livery with that silver text for the Great Western Railways. Is she getting on a train? She's getting on a train. We have our doors open. We have quite a number of coaches today. Looks like 10 coaches. 9 coaches plus our power cars. So we were in the power car at one end there. That diesel chugging away in the back. We move along back here. You can see that we have quite the long train. All in that beautiful GWR livery. Dark green with the orange and silver stripe. Here at Bristol Temple-Meads, platform 13. Looks like we have quite a crowded train, too. Here's the locomotive that we were in before we changed ends. Just going to zoom out a little bit here. You can see our station here. Quite a few platforms and tracks here in Bristol. We have the river or something or other. We have some tracks that extend on back that way, although I bet if we speed up, we'll find that they may end. Maybe not. I don't know where those go. Maybe that'll be something we discover in a future video. Anyway, back into the cab and get ready to go. We have the signal. Everyone's on board. All passengers here at Bristol Temple-Meads have boarded this London Paddington to Swansea high-speed service. Switch cabs, which we've already done, and head for Bristol Parkway. Head for Bristol Parkway we shall. Get up some speed. We'll need some power to get up some speed. Our diesel is spinning at 1300 RPMs and generating 1200 amps to move our traction motors. And off we go. 3 miles an hour as we pull slowly out. Keeping an eye on that 15 mile an hour warning. What do we have there? Electricity warning. All right. Fair enough. Now we know. A little bit more acceleration, I think. We have places to go, people to see, and things to do. But let's not go past 15 miles an hour. Now, as I said, don't forget we had that other HST pull out before us. So we will be following it a little bit, and we'll have to keep an eye on the signals. Ding? No ding. Oh, yes, ding. Oop, 15 miles an hour. There we go. And we are decelerating. Because I have the brake on. Oh, I'm very sorry, train. I have been making you work against your brake. That's rather bad practice. We are switching over to the left side, as is correct for our British trains. Remember, left-hand driving, we're on the left side of the cab and the left side of the tracks. Got a nice little map of England, well, of Britain here, I should say. Divided up. But we are in Wales today. We can go up to 25. Very good, let us do that. Sorry, I should say, in fact, we are in England, but we are in the Welsh route in Train Simulator, South Wales Coastal. So the route is Wales, that particular station is not, and we are still in England. 25 miles an hour. We can go, well, we could go to 40 momentarily, but because there is a 25 coming up, I will just stay at 25 miles an hour. Curving off to the left here toward Bristol Parkway in 5 miles. Let's see if I can pull up our scenario for the day. All right. So we picked up, we will pick up passengers, excuse me, from Bristol Parkway Platform 3. Then we will pick up passengers from Newport Platform 2. And finally, we will end up in Wales at Cardiff Central Platform 3. We have quite a long scenario today, about 50 minutes, 5-0. So I hope we have a fun journey. There is trains and there is a sunset, which always makes me happy. If you've watched some of my previous videos, you'll know that those are the two things that I'm the most fond of photographing, trains and sunsets. So if I was here in real life, I would definitely be taking a lot of photos of this train in the sunset. Our line has collapsed to two tracks. We are back over on the left with still a speed limit of 20 miles an hour. We have a green signal, so that other train has gotten sufficiently far in front of us, rolling through Lawrence Hill. There we go. There's our train going past at a sedate 25 miles an hour. Very nice. In fact, it went up to 60. I should probably be in my cab just to make sure nothing terrible is happening, but we'll be there in a moment. Nice. Screenshot taken. Let's accelerate. I'm just going to put full throttle on, 100%, as we head up to 60. That red signal is not for us, I believe. Good. Otherwise, things would be quite bad. We do need to keep an eye out for those yellow signals as we go, since that other train is theoretically in front of us, but hopefully that won't stop us for a bit. I do like how the foliage, lighting, and details in Train Simulator have been gradually improving since I first started playing it a little bit over a year ago. Yeah, look at that. Look at that nice detail. Shadows of the trees on that brickwork over there. Beautiful. See, we have an abandoned station here. Perhaps this was the old Lawrence station. I don't know. Yep. Getting AWS warning because we have a single amber light here. So I'm just going to slow down a little bit. Well, I'll release my throttle anyway and see what happens. Hopefully we have no red signals waiting for us around the bend. That would be rather unfortunate. I see we do have a hill coming up, so I'm actually going to keep a little bit of throttle on to account for that hill. We don't want to end up super late. We're already, in fact, 13 seconds late in our ETA for Bristol Parkway. And this is a 4 out of 5 difficulty rating scenario, so that means we will have some significant challenges as we go. One of those, presumably, is a very tight schedule. Up to 40 actually, because that is quite an incline. We're at 1 in 75 at the moment. It looks like it's going even worse than that. Maybe not. Maybe it's just 1 in 75. We have a signal coming up in 0.36 miles. Currently going 50 miles an hour out of our 60 limit, which is going to go up to 75 in a moment. I'm going to head outside and give you a look at this. Nice. Look at that. Look at that HST. Sad to say that, as far as I understand, the HSTs are being retired in the near future. I hope I get a chance to ride an HST before they are retired entirely, although I need to check that information once I get a little bit of a lull when I don't have yellow lights. As I try to do, I will give you a little bit of background on the train we are driving today. And because I am not as familiar with British trains as I am with US trains, I will have to learn along with you. I know that these are diesel electric trains. I believe some of them may have been converted to be dual mode diesel and electric, like the P32 ACDM, dual mode diesel electric and pure electric locomotive that we had pushing our train in episode 4 when we were on the New York New Haven line, but I'm not positive about that. We're still going up this fairly steep 1 in 77, just switched from 1 in 75 to 1 in 70, there we go, back to 1 in 75. Incline, we have some nice power lines off to our right. We have the sunset on the trees, and we are rolling along. As I said, I hope that diesel is not deafening you. I try to adjust Train Simulator's volume accordingly, so hopefully I was successful in that. We are still going rather slower than we could be. There was a derailing, all right. That repeater tells us something. I think that repeater is telling us that we have a yellow up ahead, but I'm not positive. Ah, there we go. That is a green ahead of. That's not a green for us. I will eat my hat. We are now. Our ETA has switched to being early for Bristol Parkway. All right. Derling, we have a green signal. We are good to go. We also have a speed limit of 60, so I'm going to back off on that throttle a bit. There's the speed limit sign for 60 miles an hour. Are we diverging? We are not diverging. We're going straight on. 1.74 miles to Bristol Parkway Platform 3. So let us keep an eye on that speed. I see we have a station here with a name that I'm almost certainly going too fast to read. Yep, definitely didn't read that. Who knows? There was even some HST. Whoops, we are still accelerating here a little much. HST, because we're going downhill. Stop markers there, which means you would need to overhang the loco a little bit at that station. Let's put on 14% brake, maybe? We also have a 90 coming up. Also, if you take a look at the HUD there, there's a little bit of a slightly flashing bit right after that new 60-mile-an-hour speed limit. That worries me slightly. I hope the track doesn't suddenly disappear there. One also hopes that our driving today will turn out a little bit better than our than my steam train driving a short while ago. Is that just a warning for the speed limit? Maybe. I don't know what that was about. We have a green signal coming up. Yeah, so the steam train went surprisingly well, especially given my practices that turned out horribly bad. The first one in which I stopped on an incline and couldn't get going again, and the second one in which I apparently killed my crew by leaving the firebox open going into a tunnel. But in the last few minutes of that video, episode 5, if you got a chance to watch it, I lost all the score because I started speeding, because apparently once you take the steam locomotive off the train, it can accelerate much more easily. Who'da thunk? Isn't that shocking? We are coming up to Bristol Parkway. I think it is time to do some deceleration. I was just looking at those speed limits and not at the fact that I have to stop. This does not stop very enthusiastically. Ooh, we are coming in quite a bit hot. There we go. Okay, now we're losing some nice speed. Here we are at Bristol Parkway. Okay, we're shedding speed well, not quite as fast as I'd want. I also don't want to go into emergency braking. All right, there we go. Now I can release some brakes, maybe put on a little bit of acceleration. And let's keep an eye out for that HST. There's the HST marker. That's where we want to stop. Let's get those brakes on again, because we are rapidly approaching that. 10 car HST, that's where we want to stop. We'll overhang the loco on the other end slightly, no problem there. And doors, perfect. All right. Ooh, look at that. Look at that, beautiful. I love the lighting, I love that. It really gives you the sense that that train has some slightly glossy but mostly matte paint on it. That's really nice. Our doors are open, let's head to the back and take a look. Yep, overhung that loco a bit, but did our back coach's doors open? Take a look. They did not. Oh, that's frustrating. Oh, yes, they did. The one at the other end did. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Everybody can get off. We were there a little bit early, I think. That's good. Oops, I'm going to go through the floor there. Please do not leave bags unattended. It is 18:32:36 as I just dove headfirst through that sign. Oh, dodging people, dodging doors. Got a little bit of a departures board there. No doubt not at all up to date. There's a 3 and 4 car stop. Shall we dodge into this car here for a second? Oh, those textures on those seats are shockingly low res. I'd imagine they don't get better unless we go into the actual passenger view. That would make sense. Let me bring up the HUD and let's do that. There we go, much better. So we are in one of the coaches now. Looks like we've got little overhead bins there, some nice ceiling lighting. Ooh, a nice little table here. I like working on my laptop while I travel, so presumably those are, yep, those are British power outlets, and a nice little table so we can look out the window, enjoy the scenery, and work as we go, maybe eat a nice little snack. If we're traveling with some friends, with some mates, we can have them sit across from us. So that's pleasant. Nice, nice. I like those extra little head things on the side of your headrest. Those look like they would be good for letting you nap while you ride. Anyway, let's get back into our cab and drop that HUD back down to a reasonable level. No other trains today. Very few other trains, anyway. And we are also waiting quite some time to be able to depart from Bristol Parkway Platform 3. Well, in the interest of keeping you entertained and keeping myself informed, let me read up. First, Bristol Parkway Railway Station. Oh, that's where we are now. Oh, look, there's even a nice little picture of it. Let me take a look. Oh, yeah, looks just like the picture. Very nice. I'm just looking at Wikipedia. I'll put the link in the description if people are interested, but you can also just, you know, search Bristol Parkway and click on the first link, which is invariably the Wikipedia article. It is 112 miles from London Paddington, so this train has been traveling for about 112 miles so far. It was opened in 1972 by British Rail and is the first in a new generation of park-and-ride stations. It is the third most heavily used in the west of England, after Bristol Temple-Meads and Bath Spa. Passenger boarding is complete. Change ends. Oh dear, we have to change ends. Well, isn't that unfortunate? Pull up that HUD again. Change ends. Put ourselves into forwards. I'm going to go into neutral. Go into forward. And let's see if we can get going. We have the green. It says D. I guess we are going to track D. Let's release the brakes. Let us drop the HUD once more. And let's get going. Are we going the right direction? We're going the right direction. Beautiful. 40%. Alright, and off we go. We are going to Newport Platform 2 in 21.66 miles. That is our second to last stop before Cardiff Central. So, presumably at some point, we will be moving from England to Wales. As we accelerate up to our 60 miles an hour, I think we can accelerate a little more enthusiastically than that. We will probably be ducking under the Severn today. Oh, 25 actually is our limit. Oh, hey, there's a Freightliner waiting there. Hello, Freightliner. Waiting with quite a set of Freightliner cars. Ooh, that was dangerous. It looked like we were going to crash into those. We are not. We are just headed off to the right here, towards Newport. Gotta keep an eye on that speed. Quite a rake of cars indeed. There's our Freightliner. Oops. Oh, we can go up to 60 now. Let's do so. Need another screenshot. Oh, it's time for screenshots. If you've been with my channel for a few weeks, you've seen that we've been on the South Wales coastal route once before, in which we once again went on the Severn. We were heading from Cardiff to, I think it was in fact Newport, we didn't go as far as Newport. We stopped before Newport, but I don't remember exactly where we stopped. I'd have to look that up myself. We are doing pretty much the full route available in this particular train simulator package. If you haven't picked it up yet, then you probably don't have Train Simulator 2017, because it comes free with the Train Simulator 2017 upgrade. If you wanted to get Train Simulator World, you need to expressly buy the Train Simulator 2017 package that includes this, the North Jersey coastline, and the Marseille to Avignon TGV line, and cars, and all that good stuff. Rolling through another station that we're going too fast through for me to see. That's all right. Oop, we can go up to 90 miles an hour. In fact, it looks like we're about to duck under the Severn now. That doesn't make sense. Did we go as far as Bristol Parkway in that first video? We may have. We may have indeed. I may have also tried, I may have tried some routes on my own when you guys were not there. No, I definitely went under the Severn in my first video. In my second, video. Oh well, we'll figure it out. We are rolling along at what looks like the topmost, the less steep gradient version of the two tunnels. Ducking in. Tunnel banter. We are accelerating quite nicely down this decline. I suspect once I take the throttle off, we are still going to be accelerating at a rapid pace, so I'll have to keep a finger on the brake. So it'd also be a good time to look around the cab if I knew where the cab light button was. I do not. Yep, we are still accelerating a little bit of brake. 14% brake. And I'll have to keep turning it on and off. Cab light, where are you, cab light? Quick, before I go in. Nope, too late. Ah, not too late. Cab light! Uh-oh. Desk? Can't do that. What else? Cab. Cab light! Yes! Alright. Now we have a cab light. We are no longer in a tunnel, though. Now we are in the countryside. Okay, that wasn't the same yet. Hello, HST. Aren't you nice? Ooh, we're gonna go to the back and watch you go by. Beautiful. Beautiful. Very nice. Look at this countryside. What's this? I'm gonna zoom out a little bit so you can appreciate our train in the sunset. Oh, look at that. I love it. I love it. Yes. That's what I'm talking about. That is beautiful sunset train scenery panorama vistas. That was a lot of words.
But you follow.
I'm gonna let go of that brake and let us accelerate up a little bit. Whoops. What just happened? Ah, I had my fingers slightly misaligned. I tried to turn the reverser down from 100%. Let's not do that. Beautiful. Beautiful scenery. Everything looks so much better when it's sunset, I think. Here we have another station. This time I'm going to pause and see if I can see... I don't think there were actually any signs there. I know there is a station that is one of the least used stations in Britain, and it may have been that one. It may indeed. We are heading back down again. I see quite a big tunnel coming up. And we are also accelerating. I'm going to have to keep an eye on that. So yes, I got a little carried away thinking we were going under the Severn before we were. That's all right. Yep. What am I getting beeped at for? Is it the speed limit? It's the speed limit. 75. Oh, we need to decelerate a little bit more enthusiastically than that. Even a little bit more enthusiastically than that. Sorry, passengers. I left it too late. 75. Very good. Go back down 14%. Down we go. Into this tunnel here. This looks like quite the long tunnel. Alright, now we're going into the Severn, right? This has to be. Nothing else could be this long in the tunnel. And because I've managed to find the cab light, hopefully we'll be able to take a look around our cab while we're in here. It's not a very bright cab light. Not very bright indeed. At least we can see our dials. Bogey 1 and Bogey 2. Both do not have brakes on. We do have enough brake pressure to, you know, take the brakes, put the brakes on. Actually, excuse me, it's to keep the brakes off, as we have discussed in previous videos, brake pipe pressure. There's our speedometer, just under 75 miles an hour, just under 75. Unfortunately, it looks like the digital readout is at zero. Not sure if that is supposed to be showing a speed, or if that is for where we have the equivalent of automatic train control, where we would otherwise show a speed limit there. I believe if we did have automatic train control, those little LEDs that you can see around the ring of the speedometer would also be lighting up to indicate what that speed limit was. The Acela certainly has that sort of a speedometer. English-Wales border. I think we've read about this before. I'll tell you a little bit more about the Severn Tunnel. I'm also going to back off the brakes because we've slowed down nicely and we're going to go up a hill soon. Yes, I have indeed looked at this before. Pronounced not in Welsh. You do not pronounce it Tunnel Hafren, even though that's what it looks like. Definitely not the correct pronunciation. Remember that we are going through 4 miles of tunnel, even though only 2.25 are under the river. The rest is to give us a shallow enough decline and incline that trains can actually go up and down it. It was the longest mainline railway tunnel within the UK for 100 years, until HS1 was built, the tunnel for HS1, under London. The two major HS1 tunnels, excuse me, London East and London West. Let's learn more about the HST, the GWR HST. Is this the Class 43? I do believe. Beautiful, if you look on Wikipedia, a nice picture of this exact train going along what looks like... that looks like the English Riviera, in fact, on which we were in my last video. passing Spray Point. That is quite pretty. Quite pretty indeed, with the cliffs behind it. A little bit dirtier and more marked up than the train we are driving today. Also, we are 47 seconds late, so let's get right up to that 75. The interior doesn't look quite like what we have in here. The upholstery is gray with green headrests instead of that kind of tan beige color that we saw when we went into passenger view a short time ago. The youngest Class 43 HST locomotive is now 29 years old. Your fun fact of the day. The class is due to be replaced on some routes as part of the Intercity Express program by the Class 800 and the Class 802. We drove a Class 801 in the third video I made when we went from Peterborough to London's King's Cross. And then there will be electric diesel hybrids on the Great Western Main Line in 2016 and then Wales in 2017. So it sounds like I am indeed quickly running out of an opportunity to ride these trains in real life. So that is very sad. They were refurbished by Bombardier between 2006 and 2008 with leather seats in first class, new toilets, a redesigned buffet, and at-seat power points. The company opted for mainly airline seats, giving more seats per train. Well, I have to say that I object to that. Being a long-legged individual, I do not fit well on airline, excuse me, in airline seats, especially legroom-wise, but they're also quite narrow. I am not a very wide person, but, you know, it's still cramped. Nobody enjoys flying on airplanes. Bit of a sip of water, excuse me there. Repeater says we are set to go on ahead. And we have now dropped nicely to under that 70 mile an hour speed limit we're heading towards. We are also heading straight into the sun. If this was real life, I would definitely be blinded by that sun. It is not, so I am not. That is good. Otherwise, I have to pull down my little blind here. Do I have a little blind I can pull down? I have a little blind. Ooh, that's rather a lot of blind. Go away, blind. Passing through another station. I should pull up the route map here so I know what stations I'm heading through. What else do I want to tell you about the Class 43? I don't know. What do we see here? The HSTs have automatic train protection and automatic warning system, ATP and AWS. And if either one is faulty, the train is not used. We can go back up 75. So because we're running this train today, it must mean we have both functioning AWS and ATP. So that's good. Want to make sure we don't have any crashes today. That would not be good. Whoops. I almost sped up a little too enthusiastically there. Darling, heading to Newport Platform 2 in just 9 miles. So we're making good progress. Now we are in Wales. We can start speaking Welsh. Let's not do that. I don't know how to pronounce Welsh words. You guys might. I certainly don't. It would be fun to learn, but I have not done so. So now we are back on tracks that you have traveled with me already in my episode 2 when we were heading from Cardiff. We may actually have headed all the way to Newport. I may be misremembering just how extensive that video was. I thought it was a relatively short video. Who knows? I'm tempted to watch my own video while I record this video and find out for sure. But that sounds a little dangerous and a little egotistical. Let's get up to that 90. We don't want to be late. We're already 30 seconds late, although we've been chipping away at that. Oh, that sun would be absolutely blinding me if this was real life. I guess we're headed straight west. Great Western Railways indeed. If we're heading the other way, would it be the Great Eastern Railway? Railways? I don't think so. I don't think it works that way. Ooh, the Class 180. In the dynamic livery looks quite pretty. You should take a look at that if you're not familiar with it. It has the same yellow front that I believe is compulsory for British trains, but also has blue sides with an electric magenta and blue kind of helical stripe along the side. Quite pretty. I'm just reading about the Great Western Railway now. Quite a bit to read about. All right, enough of that. But also, not speed. That would not be good. Somehow, I'm going to knock my table. Knock wood. We have succeeded in not speeding so far in this route. We have 500 points. there's absolutely no way I'm going to finish this route with a perfect score, especially if I do things like look at my own video. I'm going to do it. I'm going to look at my own video. I'm going to look at episode 2, class 175, Winter Welsh Morning, and I'm going to see how far we went. We did go as far as Bristol Parkway. So there we go. It was a 40-minute video. I didn't actually remember it being that long. Yep, that happened. All right. It was a snowy morning. It's rather less snowy today. But I did, in fact, go all the way to Bristol Parkway. So we're basically doing the same route in reverse this time in an HST. A significantly more powerful train than that Class 175. We're keeping a nice, slightly under 90 miles an hour with that 20%. Actually, let me go up to a little bit of a faster speed. Now we're 22 seconds late. Excellent. 89 miles an hour. All right, let me drop to 20% and see where that keeps us. We'll probably keep speeding up a little bit, so I'll probably want to drop that down to zero shortly. The sun is still setting. I expected it to be set by now as we roll along. Ooh, look at that. I like that a lot. This is a very pretty train. I have to say I'm not entirely a fan of the compulsory yellow fronts. Nope, other way. Okay. They're a little bit stark, especially on locomotives that have a paint scheme that doesn't really go with yellow. Although I suppose since that is required, there are not many paint schemes that have been designed without the yellow and then have the yellow applied, so they do generally look pretty good with the yellow front. But there we go. There we go indeed. We want to be safe, so yellow fronts it is. Beautiful sky. I would like to be watching this sunset in real life as we cruised along through the Welsh countryside. Whoops, AWS. Yep, speed limit. That was definitely just a warning. Now that other train I guess got rather far ahead of us because although I believe it was headed in the same direction, I have seen neither hide nor hair of it, and we have not run into any yellows. I also went a little bit slowly going out of Bristol Temple-Meads, so that could be part of why we didn't see any amber yellow lights. 75 warning, I hope we're not crossing over. I hope we don't have an unexpected 40, that would be rather bad. Almost down to the 75, so I'm not going to release the brakes now and see if we can just drift down to 75.9 miles an hour. I don't think I've mentioned this in a previous video. Oh, we are going down a decline. We do need some brakes. But Train Simulator says that you can be going no more, for example, than 75 miles an hour if the speed limit is 75, and it considers 75.9 miles an hour to be 75 miles an hour. So as long as you're going strictly less than 76 miles an hour, you are okay, and you're not going to have your score brutally decremented. Darling. Headed to Newport Platform 2 in just over 2 miles. We also have a 40 coming up, so let's keep an eye on that. I see a couple more houses on the side, so we must be getting to a slightly more built-up area. A crane as well. It looks like we've got some sunset construction going on in the town of Newport. That looks like a bridge above us. I was going to say it's a pedestrian bridge, but it's in fact a road. We're going 72 with that 40 rapidly approaching. I see we have a little bit of a maybe an extra rail yard over there. We passed a freight train a short time ago. I didn't really comment on it because I was busy talking about other things. Yes, it doesn't like that I haven't started decelerating yet, so let's do a little deceleration. Nice and gently so our passengers don't get discomfited, don't get battered around a bit. Certainly not that drive quality problem that I had in my steam train where I suddenly started, although only me as an engineer and maybe my fireman would have been impacted by that. We're not slowing down enough. Let's slow down more. We need to get to 40 in 0.28 miles, quarter of a mile to lose 13 miles an hour speed. I think we can do that indeed. Maybe not at this level of braking though. 47, 46, 45, 44, okay. 42, 41, 40. Beautiful. Beautiful. 40.4 miles an hour rolling into Newport with less than a mile until we reach the start of the platform. Ooh, I see we have another train coming. We have another train waiting for us, it appears. Hello, train. You are a Freightliner. Darling. Where are you headed to, Freightliner? Do you have cars. You do have cars. Very good. We've got a 30 coming up. We'll want to keep aware of that. Curving into Newport. Very nice. Very nice. That sky is beautiful. I know I've said it, but it bears repeating. It's also that weird little flash that you sometimes get in train simulator clouds. I don't know what that's about. I don't think it's supposed to be just random lightning. All right, let's start decelerating for that 30 now. Maybe at 28%. 28%? There we go. 37, 36, 35. Yeah, I think we'll make that. 34. Such derailing. Much derailing. Wow. 31. Back off the brakes now. I usually like to, for some reason, I've come up with the rule of thumb that I like to go into platforms at about 36 miles an hour, and I seem to be to aim for that regardless of what kind of train I'm driving. It seems to pretty much work out well for me. But there we go. I don't know where I came up with that. Just playing and seeing what happened. All right, let's do a little bit more braking. 28% maybe, graduated self-lap. We'll look for that HST marker. A little bit more braking, 42%. There we go. Ooh, we've got another class 175 over there, like the one that we drove. In fact, it is traveling exactly the same route as it appears, excuse me. Running over my own words and my excitement about seeing that. Here is Newport. Where is our HST stop? I think I may have just gone past it, so I'm going to put some more brakes on. It looks like it's not until up there, but according to the HUD, that little green area is where you're supposed to stop. So I'm just going to stop here and open the doors. Have I opened the doors? I have not opened the doors. Why have the doors not opened? Hello? Doors. We're at Newport. Definitely supposed to stop at Newport. I'm going to pause this and wonder what has gone terribly wrong. Do I need to back up? Is it angry at me for passing the signal? Does it think I missed the platform? This is odd. I don't think I've had this happen to me before. We're also rather late. Well, this is very odd indeed. I think I'm going to get a penalty at this point for being late as well. What is this symbol? It's like this means let the passengers off. Well, excuse me while I stop this video and see if I can figure out what has happened. Apparently we're 11.77 miles away, but I know that's a bug. So it looks like there are a couple of... What? Oh dear. All right. Well, hello viewers. So, let me tell you what happened. Apparently I spatted without noticing it. Signal passed at danger. Luckily, I saved the game at Newport because I was having some troubles there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to reload the save at Newport, and I am going to try this again. I also lost 13 points, 12 points for speeding, 1 point for emergency brake application by accident. So, if you are seeing this, what it means is I have decided to just crop this part of the video in, show you it, and pretty much go back and try again. So, basically, you saw me get confused trying to stop at Newport. There's a slight bug in this particular route that doesn't let you properly stop at Newport. Now you've seen this little ending where everything went horribly wrong when I was almost at Cardiff. Now I am going to go back to Newport. You will rejoin me pretty much where you left off, where everything was going relatively well other than the little bug, and we will hopefully have a successful run to Cardiff. I am not going to pass the signal at danger that time. So, see you back at Newport in a moment. Hello, dear viewer. So, if you just saw that little blurb, you know that this is my second attempt to do this. You probably just saw me get really confused because I was unable to get this train to acknowledge that I was at Newport and I could not open my doors. Then there was a little disconnected blur because there is a segment that you will not see where I succeeded in getting the train to open its doors, got most of the 11¾ miles from Newport to Cardiff, and then went through a signal at danger. I went through a signal at red. I actually have to also reveal that there is a second attempt in which I sped exactly as I did in that very first attempt. Once I had gotten everything sorted at Newport, I suddenly jumped from 50 to 51.5 miles an hour just outside the tunnel that we have to go through after Newport. I'm going to keep a closer eye on my speed this time because something really strange is happening there. I don't think it was me just not keeping an eye on going down a hill two times in a row. I think I had eased off the throttle. So I decided, in the interest of trying to get a perfect score, because I'm a bit of a perfectionist and don't want to get 988 points when I could get 1,000 points, that I would just start over again, and hopefully it goes well this time. So, first things first, we need to get this train to open its doors. We are going to do that by reversing into the green area, and with a bit of guessing and checking, I discovered that that is the way to make this particular scenario, which is ever so slightly bugged, acknowledge the fact that we are in the station. So, unpause, put the train into reverse, take off the brakes, put on some throttle, head backwards from this outside view, watch until we're nearly in. All right, ease off the throttle. Sorry about the trees. Add some brakes, all the brakes, lots of brakes. Stop the train. Train is stopped, open the doors. There we go, now we're good. I'm also gonna put the train back into forwards. The very first time I tried to do this again, the train started going backwards because I forgot to put it back into forwards when I finished that little maneuver. Let's take a nice little screenshot here. Beautiful. This is going to be a very brief stop. I will go into free camera and look around a bit. Oops, not to do that. That's the wrong button. Sometimes I use WASD when I mean to use arrows to move the camera around. That is a very frustrating bug, that the train will not stop properly at the station. There we go. If you overhang the locomotive even a little bit, let us release the brakes. Let us put on the accelerator straight up 60%. And we will try to get to 30 miles an hour. And once again, we will try to go the 11.77 miles to Cardiff Central, Platform 3. This is now my third attempt in very quick succession to do this. As I said, the first time, I got almost all the way to Cardiff Central, and then I SPADed because I had done so. I decided not to just end the video there, but I had resaved here. Luckily, I had saved at Newport. Actually, if I had not saved at Newport, I don't know what I would have done. I don't think I would have wanted to redo this video from the beginning. So I might have just ended the video there with a very disappointed Kermartian. Never a dull moment in a Kermartian video, hopefully. Although we do want some relaxed times when our passengers and our driver can just enjoy the scenery. And then the second time, right outside this tunnel that we're nearing, I sped up again, and because I had had a save point at Newport such a short time earlier, I decided I would just start over there, re-record another 5 minutes of video, and try to get a perfect score. I would like to get a perfect score in one of these videos. Derling? No, Derling. That was the second one. As I've said the last two times, you will hear a freight train off to our left in the parallel brick line tunnel. Not that. That's just me accelerating. There, now you can hear it. You can hear some flange squeal from the train to our left. Yep. But once we get out of the tunnel, you will not see it. And if I try to swing around and look, I will see nothing because there's a train behind us. All right, so let's slow down. Let's just release the throttle. We're at 43 miles an hour. And as we near the signal, something weird happens. Okay, so there is a slight decline of 1 in 105, and that is why I was speeding up. It wasn't some strange bug. Yeah, actually, we get quite a bit of acceleration going down that hill. I just kept missing the fact that there was a hill there and speeding. So that was frustrating. Hopefully everything will go well from here on in. I won't spad, I won't speed, and everything will run smoothly. All right, we are in the 75. Let's head right up to 75. We were a little bit late coming out of getting into Newport. Excuse me, we were about a minute and a half to 2 minutes late because of that confusion with the doors, and we were already running a few seconds late, 30 seconds late or so, I think. And there's also another bug in this, because of whatever, I think it's related to what happened at Newport, but you'll notice that the ETA and the number of miles left until we reach Cardiff Central will not change through this entire run. We'll be nearly at Cardiff, and it'll still say 11.77 miles, ETA 7:12 p.m. and 9 seconds. So we don't really have a sense of how long is left until Cardiff and if we're going to be there on time, but we'll do our best and see what happens. I'm going to take another sip of water, excuse me. Ah, water successfully sipped. It makes my throat quite dry to keep talking for an hour. This is in fact a 60 minute scenario. I think I said it was a 50 minute scenario. It is in fact a full 60 minutes, 60, 1 hour. I also said the very first time I tried to do this that I've been enjoying this series very much. When I play on my own, it's nice as a kind of relaxing zen sort of thing to do, where I just watch the miles roll by, manage the train speed, think my own thoughts, and pretty much do what a train driver would do while driving a train. Hopefully concentrating enough to do a good job. I usually get pretty good scores when I'm playing by myself, as long as it's on a route that I've played on before and I know the twists and turns and speed limits and everything. We are going flat out, by the way, and not really getting up to that 95. Hopefully we will soon. We'll also have a series of ambers going to Cardiff, which I now know. I guess those ambers were leading to a red that I missed. I'm really upset that I missed that red. And went through that signal of danger. I see the sun is still gradually setting on us. I saw a flash of orange there. Oh, that's a screenshot I need. Not with the trees, not with the trees. There we go. Let me also not speed trying to do that. <laughs> 94.1 miles an hour, very nice. I do love sunsets and I do love trains and I do love photos of both. I don't really have that many photos of both together. That would be nice to have more of in my collection. Living in a big city doesn't really lend itself well to a lot of train spotting. If I lived in a slightly more rural environment along a train line, I definitely would be there train spotting in nice weather at nice sunsets. I do get to look at subways a lot. I like subways. I like the subway system here. But not really the same thing. At one point, I believe they decided it was illegal to take photos of subways. I don't know if that's still the case. A little bit of an overreaction, if you ask me. Certainly, there are many more people who want to take photos of subways because, you know, they're a New York institution than because they have bad things they want to do. But who knows? Who knows indeed? Let's keep right up around that 95. We're really speeding along here. Quite nice in our HST. It's sad that our HST doesn't get to do a lot of HS-ing as we go. Let's go to the back of our train. Let me ease off the throttle. Let me sit out the back of our train and take a look. Oh, that's pretty. I'm a real sucker for orange skies. As I was commenting, the environmental things here, like the skies in Train Simulator, have gotten so much better. I really like them. I think I read something about the engine that they use, not a locomotive, but the, you know, game engine that they use to make their skies. Train Simulator Q, 75 coming up. Oh, here's the freight train. I passed this freight train the first time and took some photos with it, some screenshots with it. I'm also going to have to do some deceleration, but let me get this screenshot first. Aha! We must have been slightly later the first time, because I could not get these two together in one screenshot. There we go. That's quite nice. I quite like that indeed. Let's do one like that. That emphasizes our train. Let's do one like that. Very nice. And can we get one like this? That's not going to work. Maybe like that. Not bad. Not the best screenshot ever. I'll take it. All right. Let's get back into our cab and keep going. Now let's decelerate. 42% brakes. I totally forget what I was talking about. Sky. Ah, I wanted to know what the sky and stuff that they use is. Come back off the brakes now. Ding. Hello, HST, and goodbye, HST. It does not say what the TSX engine, which is what we're using, uses for its sky, although I'm pretty confident they used an external environment engine of some sort, because I think I researched it for a personal project of my own. Get back up to that 75, if we don't mind. With 11.77 miles left to Cardiff, that's a lie. One would hope that we have less than 9 minutes of driving left. Oops, I was about to speed. Let's not do that. Ooh, this is stressful trying to get a perfect score. Right, so as I was saying, it's fun to just relax and play the game as I think I've said in previous videos, I strongly recommend you try it, even if you're not the world's biggest train buff and you have no particular aspirations to drive trains in real life. It's fun to just kind of drive along in Train Simulator, look at the scenery, keep an eye on the speed, and think your engineer thoughts. Is that a Class 175 coming up? There should be a Class 175 coming up at some point. It's a little bit different recording, of course, because, you know, you have to think about both driving and driving properly, and also keeping up some kind of engaging dialogue as you go. Now, see, I'm going to start forgetting what I said in the first version of this that you're not going to see, and the first version of this before Newport, which you did see. I think I did not say, although I may have, that I would enjoy doing a recording where I was streaming as well, so I could have more of a conversation with you guys and not just be monologuing. I apologize profusely if I did, in fact, hello, Class 175, there you are, say that in the first version, and you are hearing me say that for a second time. If you are in favor of that, yes, I know. Please do let me know, and I will try to schedule these in advance so I can both stream and record and, you know, have you guys there to offer your thoughts and feedback and just kind of keep me company while I do it. So there we go. That would be a lot of fun. All right, we are nearing Cardiff. The game engine is very much not keeping up with us. Frame rate is suffering a little. We have a yellow there. We are under the 40. Then we're going to have a 30 shortly after that, and then a 20, and then a 15. I believe it is rather before that that I ended up spadding single pass danger. Yep, AWS. Just warning me about that speed limit. I think, unless it's also about this signal, this caution signal. I also believe that I mentioned in the first version of this that I really like this brick architecture. I like that Britain has had a lot more time to build up brick and stone architecture, and somewhat less time than we have had here to get a little too enthusiastic about trying to make everything out of glass and metal and thinking that everything should be what is now monotonous, boring glass and metal. Is that red for me? I think that... Oh, it just went yellow. All right, so we are definitely chasing another train in. Yep, I hear it. I'm going to have to keep very close eye on this set of signals from here on in to make sure that we do not pass a signal at danger. I know we can at least get safely past the footbridge nearing Cardiff Central Station before everything goes terribly wrong, because that's where it went wrong last time. Our high-speed train is no longer doing very much high-speeding. That is all right. Wouldn't it be nice to have a little backyard behind your house facing on a nice four-track via like this, where you could just watch interesting trains go by all day long? HSTs and Class 175s and Freightliners and who knows what else. I'd imagine it would also get somewhat noisy, but not too bad. A very good acquaintance of mine. People that I know have a house that is directly in front of a freight line. Every once in a while you can hear the rattle of a freight train going by. When it's winter, you can see it through the trees, and it's especially cool if you go closer to the tracks and you can watch the trains rumble by. Also, the way their living room is arranged, their dining room, excuse me, you can actually look out the window, and if it's at the, you know, dark enough outside, you can see the headlights of the approaching trains because the tracks kind of curve towards their house and then behind their house. So, really cool to see a freight train's headlights coming at night. I know. And just hear the rumble of the heavy cars passes. Whoops, didn't mean to hit that. 60 or 80 or 100 car freight train just rolls past. There's another 175. Hello, 175. This time I'll intentionally honk at you. All right, here's the footbridge. Here's where everything went horribly, terribly wrong the first time around. Somewhere here there's a very sneaky little signal that wants to be read at us. Or a big signal and I just was too busy talking and didn't notice it. So that is the danger as well. We are very much in the center of Cardiff now. I see we have giant apartment buildings. That looks like a red. That's probably the red I went through. We have a 20-mile-an-hour limit coming up, so we would probably want to... Oh, yep. Brakes for days. Yep, I see the red. Let me zoom out so I know how far... Oh, I'm further away from this red than I thought. Let us not go through the red light. Oh, I also commented that because there's that little ramp off to our left, I got very confused, and I thought that this was an incline, that we were going up here. I was just confused about the fact that those tracks going to our left are in fact going up, not going level. I thought they were level and we were going, you know, up at this point, or down if we were going the other way. Class 175 crawling along over there. In fact, what is the case is that is going down from our perspective and we are level. So it goes to show you what odd perspective can do. And that class 175 just reversed. So I don't know what that's about. I bet we have to wait for that 175. We are just kind of drifting towards this light at 1.6 miles an hour. I think we're going to stop naturally just with our own friction before we get there. And we'll wait for that class 175 to cross our tracks like an inconsiderate little train. But it's all right. We won't mind. We shall not complain. Alrighty. So we're nearly at Cardiff. I hope you've been enjoying this. We are now going backwards. Let's not do that. Let's instead put some brakes on when we're stopped so we don't just roll backwards. Sorry, passengers. Now I'm going to put a little brakes on. It's probably going to be unnecessary because there we go. Of course, the light immediately turns yellow. Release the brakes, put on some acceleration. Probably try not to go over 15 miles an hour because we have a 15 coming up very soon. You can see the little indicator up there on the signal shows that we are going into platform 3. Cleared into platform 3. So let us do that. Let us just head right for platform 3. Our passengers here have had quite a journey, something like 180 miles, I want to say, since it was 112 miles from Paddington to Bristol Parkway, according to that Wikipedia article that I read at you. And then we've gone quite a bit of a ways. We went from Bristol Parkway under, ooh, the lights all just turned on. It must be really nighttime now. Under the Severn, all the way to Newport, and now we are nearly at Cardiff. So they have had quite a journey if they've come from London all the way here to Cardiff. Definitely sounds like a fun route to ride, if I do say so myself. With all those lights on and all this geometry in Cardiff, I see my frame rate is suffering slightly, but that's quite all right. We are nearly there. I will make sure we have enough momentum to get actually into this station. Let's see if the doors will actually open this time. That would be pleasant. That was rather frustrating at Newport. But thank you for bearing with me. This has been a very fun journey. I've enjoyed driving some British Rails. Hopefully I will be driving the TGV next time, unless I find something else that I would rather drive. I think I also said this in a part of the video that you did not see, but I need to learn a little bit more about French train signaling on the TGV. I think I did say that in this version. Well, anyway, train signaling on the TGV is complicated. Maybe I'll make a video showing just how complicated. I know, I see the red. It is. So you can also be amazed at just how many different ways you can configure French high-speed signals. All right, we are nearly at the end of this platform, which means we are nearly at the end of our journey for today. And it looks like we're going to get a perfect score. I may even show you the final score screen, which I usually quit before, just to show off what a perfect score we have. I mean, I haven't actually stopped yet, so, you know, let's not get too excited. Let's stop right around here. I think there's the HST marker right there on that light pole. I'm a little bit early, but there we go. We are 19 seconds early. Very exciting. Let's hop out, see where we ended up. Yeah, the HST marker is right there. HST, 2 plus 8 car, that's what we have. 8 coaches and 2 power cars. I think I might have said 9 plus 2. It is 8 plus 2. There we go. There is our train, stopped at last after its long journey from London's Paddington station. Take another screenshot because, of course, walk along this train. Everybody should have left. Maybe this train goes even further. I don't think so. These people don't seem very keen on leaving our train. Well, they just must like trains a great deal, as we do. As I do, anyway. You don't have to like trains. You can just tolerate trains. As long as you enjoy these videos, though, I am happy. All tasks completed successfully. Let's see how well you did. Well, let us see how well we did indeed. 1,000 points. 1,000 XP gained. Gold star. 36,268 XP total. It says I was on time to Newport. I severely disagree. I was supposed to be there at 1854, and I got there at 1856. 18 Maybe that's the time I left. I think that's more likely. Still, I was definitely not on time. Anyway, this has been a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed the Class 43 HST on the South Wales Coastal Line heading from, well, the line is from Paddington to Cardiff. In this case, we were going from Bristol Temple-Meads all the way to Cardiff. I hope you enjoyed our journey through the sunset. Enjoyed learning a little bit. I didn't tell you as much as I have in the past, but a little bit about the Class 43, about the Great Western Railway, about what else? About Bristol Parkway, I told you a little bit about. I do hope to drive something in the next video. The TGV is a very good option. Maybe a little short video on the TGV signaling tutorials first, so we can boggle at them together, and then another video where I actually drive the TGV. Who knows, though, if I will find something else interesting to drive. If I do, then I will certainly end up driving that. And I will also be happy to take your suggestions. I enjoyed the suggestion that I drive a steam train. That was fun last time, and I will definitely drive another steam train in a future video. I will do the very idiomatic and a little bit annoying, hopefully not annoying, habit of, as YouTubers tend to do, inviting you to like this video if you enjoyed it. I hope that you will subscribe if you're enjoying the series, so you will know when I put up new videos about trains, about Train Simulator, about Minecraft, about electronics, about other interesting things I like to post videos about. I'll definitely have a video about TI's, Texas Instruments' new innovator hub, a new little tool they introduced to teach electronics and electrical engineering in the classroom, which seems like something cool. Anyway, I would be happy to see your comments, your suggestions, your feedback in the comments section about this video, about my past videos, about my future videos. And thank you for being with me. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.